In this video, I'll talk how I work with components in Angular. And with this, I begin a series on Angular clean architecture. At least that's how I see it. After each episode, I plan to commit the code discussed in the video to a public repository. With every new video, the code base will grow, so you can see the whole thing. Perhaps in the future, this will evolve into a true open source application. And of course, your likes and subscriptions will be the best motivation for me. The user experience on desktop and mobile devices can be very different, and sometimes responsive design in itself is not a choice. This is why I prefer to split the front-end application into two parts, the desktop application and the mobile application. You see two corresponding folders, and the third folder is shared and contains everything that will be used for both parts of application. The desktop and mobile versions are implemented as lazy loading Angular modules. In the root application routing module, I determine whether the device is mobile or desktop. I do this using device detector service, which internally uses a window ref service to get the actual screen size of the device. I have established that all devices with a screen smaller than 768 pixels are mobile. In many projects, I have seen developers store all the components they have in a components folder. For a large project, this could be hundreds, and for me, it's a mess. To keep components organized, I like to use three types of subfolders within the components folder: screens, common, redirects. In the screens folder, I store components that can be thought of as an entire application screen. In website terminology, we can call these pages: home screen, login screen, profile, and others. Essentially, these are all the routing components in your application. The common folder contains reusable components that can be used in multiple places in a project. For example, an avatar component. In fact, this folder can be called reusable, which reflects its essence. The redirects folder contains components that handle incoming redirect requests from third-party APIs. It's a special case of screens, but for an external request, so I store them separately. Another type we can distinguish is subcomponents. This is the non-reusable part of the parent component that we get when we're decomposing a large complex component. For example, the home screen contains the subcomponent home bottom panel, which is actually just a part of the parent component. Decomposing the components allows them to keep them smaller and cleaner. You may mention that I use the prefix MB for mobile components and DT for desktop components. And shared components like avatar do not have prefixes. This helps me easily distinguish components and navigate. A common way to pass data to a component is through input properties. An input property must always have an explicit type. But sometimes you need to pass a list of parameters, and this list may grow during development, and some parameters may be optional. To avoid clutter, I suggest using the interface associated with the component and storing it in the same folder, like I do for the avatar component. A developer who wants to use this component can easily check the interface and know what the parameter list looks like. I don't use the popular BAM methodology or something like this for naming CSS classes in my components. Instead, I never disable view encapsulation for components to prevent naming conflicts and incorrect styling. Also, breaking it down into small components helps you maintain order and debug your source code. One more recommendation I can give you based on my experience: keep Angular lifecycle hooks methods like ng on init more lightweight. Use separate private methods to access root parameters, retrieve API data, or perform some calculations and set component properties. For example, here I am setting the avatar's parameters, and I wrap this in a separate method. And here I set some properties and adjust the avatar text size in the ng after view init hook method using separate methods with meaningful names. In the following videos, I'll cover models, mappers, API interactions, and state management with ng access. The code base on GitHub will also be constantly expanded. So subscribe to my channel and don't forget about the likes. Thank you.